So we now come to the hypothesis test unit number 2. And we just put together what we learned in the previous hypothesis test unit and in the unit on confidence intervals. So this ends up to be the dominant way of doing hypothesis testing. And we arrive at a very simple formula that we can even program. So according to Wikipedia, in the 2007-08 season, the average NBA basketball player was 6 feet and 6.98 inches tall. That is the same as 200.66 centimeters. Or for the sake of this exercise, just 200 centimeters. Let me question this and see if this is actually acceptable. So go to a training game for NBA players. So here they are training. And I drag all the players on the side and I take their height. And as I take those measurements, I find here are the sizes I observe. In fact, I get everything from 199 centimeters to 206 in 1 centimeter increments. And now I'm going to ask the two-sided hypothesis test question whether I shall reject the claim that the average player in the NBA is 200 centimeters at a 95% confidence level. So the trick goes as follows. You learned about confidence intervals, which is the mean plus minus a probability factor, a factor taken from the t-table times the square root of the empirical variance over n. That formula you've now seen many times and practiced. When I plug this in here with the appropriate a, I get for the mean 202.5 plus minus 1.916. If you want to check this, I'm using 2.365 for a. Graphically, what this means is if here's the 200 and here are my data points, the mean measurement of the sample sits over here, and the 95% confidence interval, it stops at 200.58, just short of 200. And that means we reject the hypothesis of 200 centimeter based on our sample of 8 people, because the confidence interval doesn't quite make it there. Now I should argue that this isn't quite correct in practice. Depending on what that town I go to, I might find a different sample than a different town. We say we didn't pick these people completely independently and it isn't accounted here. And that's just a word of caution. But I think you get the principle. It's really simple. Use your confidence interval and check whether the outcome lies within or outside the confidence interval.